Hello, children. I'd like to welcome you to Story Time with Winnie and Nan. I'm Nan, and this is Winnie. And during our time together, Winnie's going to be helping me share with you some of my favorite books. We'll also be creating a craft to go along with each of the books that we read so that you can remember the story and share it with your family and friends. Okay, children, today you can ask the grown-up that's there with you to collect some things that you will need for your craft at the end of the books. So today, what you'll need is, you'll need 5 paper plates, a scissors, some crayons, a pencil, 3 straws, and some clear tape. So if you can ask a grown-up that's there with you to collect these things for you, you'll be all ready to do the crafts after we read each of our books. And in honor of Winnie, the first book I'd like to share with you today is all about dogs. And the title is Dogs, Dogs. And this book talks about all the different personalities that dogs have. And at the end, we're going to think about kind of a dog we are, or we would be. So let's go with this first book. Fast dogs. Fast dog, fast dog, in such a chase, I think you must be in some big race. Little dogs. Little dog, little dog, oh so cute, take a ride in my rain boot. Fat dog. Fat dog, fat dog, just look at you eat. I think you've had too many treats. Sad dog. Sad dog, sad dog, you seem so glum. Let's go play with your favorite chum. A chum is a friend. So dogs play with their friends too. Pretty dog. Pretty dog, pretty dog. What a fancy bow. You're ready to win ribbons at a show. Lazy dog. Lazy dog, lazy dog, just lying still. Not even this ball gives you a thrill. Happy dog. Happy dog, happy dog. Why do you bark? It must be because we're going to the park. I take Winnie to the park, and he gets all excited. He loves to go. Scared dog. Scared dog, scared dog, shivering under the rug. It's okay, you just need a great big hug. Dirty dog. Dirty dog, dirty dog, digging lots. No bones are hiding in the flower pots. He shouldn't be digging in the flower pot. Shaggy dog. Shaggy dog, shaggy dog, with so much hair. Do you really have eyes under there? Stubborn dog. Stubborn dog, stubborn dog, pulling away. There's just a little rain today. That's what Winnie does. He doesn't like to go out in the rain. Big dog. Big dog, big dog. What a giant you are. You're almost as big as a little car. Dogs, dogs. Little girl, little boy, reading this book. Which dog are you like? Take a look. Which dog do you think you'd be? Let's look at Winnie right now and see what kind of a dog he is right now. What kind of a dog do you think Winnie is right now? I think he's being a lazy dog. What do you think? Okay, children. The books that I brought to share with you today are all by the same author, and you may have read books by her. Her name is Laura Numeroff, and she wrote several books that are called circle books. And you know what a circle is. A circle is a shape like this, and it has no beginning and no end. It just keeps on going. And that's what these books are. And I brought several books by Laura Numeroff, and the first one, they're circle books because they end right where they began. The first one I'm going to share with you, you may be familiar with. It's called, If You Give a Mouse a Cookie. So off we go to enjoy this first story. If you give a mouse a cookie, there he is, he's going to ask for a glass of milk. When you give him the milk, he'll probably ask you for a straw. When he's finished, he'll ask for a napkin. Look at how full he looks. His tummy is full. Then he'll want to look in the mirror to make sure he doesn't have a milk mustache. When he looks into the mirror, he might notice his hair needs a trim. So he'll probably ask for a pair of nail scissors. Those are those tiny little scissors that someone might cut their nails with. When he's finished giving himself a trim, he'll want a broom to sweep up. He'll start sweeping. He might get carried away and sweep every room in the house. He may even end up washing the floors as well. When he's done, he'll probably want to take a nap. You'll have to fix up a little box for him with a blanket and a pillow. He'll crawl in, make himself comfortable, and fluff the pillows a few times. He'll probably ask you to read him a story. So, you'll read to him from one of your books, and he'll ask to see the pictures. When he looks at the pictures, he'll get so excited that he'll want to draw a picture of his own. He'll ask for paper and crayons. He'll draw a picture. When the picture is finished, he'll want to sign his name with a pen. Then he'll want to hang his picture on your refrigerator, which means he'll need, let's see what he puts it on with, scotch tape. He'll hang up his drawing and stand back to look at it. Looking at the refrigerator will remind him that, what do you keep in the refrigerator that he's going to be reminded of? He's thirsty. So, he'll ask for a glass of milk. And chances are, if he asks for a glass of milk, what's he going to want with his milk? He's going to want a cookie to go with it. So we started with a cookie and we ended with a cookie. This is the puppet that we're going to make to go along with If You Give a Mouse a Cookie. And it's a cookie puppet. So the first thing you're going to need to do is take one of your paper plates and you'll need your pencil. And first thing we're going to do is we're going to draw the cookie. I'll put this here so we can see it. I'm going to draw a cookie. And we're going to draw on the inside of the paper plate with our pencil. It doesn't have to be a perfect circle. And then we'll take our scissors. And if you don't know how to use a scissors, you can ask the grown-up that's there with you to help you cut out your cookie. So we're just going to go around like this, and it doesn't have to be perfect because I know when I make cookies, they're not perfect circles. So that was easy. So here we have our cookie. And I think my favorite cookie is a chocolate chip cookie. But I also like M&M cookies. So the first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to color my cookie dark because I baked it, and I baked it just right, so it's delicious. So here's my cookie, and it's all baked. So we're going to color in our circle and make our cookie. So the next thing I'm going to do is I'm going to put my chocolate chips, because I made a chocolate chip cookie. So I'm going to put my chocolate chips in. I'm going to put a lot of chocolate chips because I really like a lot of chocolate chips in my cookie. So I'm going to put some chips here, and I'll put a chip here, and I'll put a chip here. But remember, I said I also like M&M cookies. So I'm going to take some of my other colored crayons, and I'm going to put in some M&Ms. And I like the red ones, so I'm going to put a red M&M here. I'm going to put a red M&M here. But I also like the green ones. So I'm going to put a green one here. And I think I'll put a green one here. And then one more. I think I'll put a yellow one over here. Okay. So there is my cookie, my chocolate chip M&M cookie. So now to make my puppet, I'm just going to take one of my straws, and I'll turn it over. I'm going to put the straw in the back, and I'll take some of my clear tape, cut a piece, and put the tape right there on the straw. And there you are. And there we have our cookie puppet.
Okay, now that we've finished our craft, the second story that we're going to read, also by Laura Numeroff, is called If You Give a Cat a Cupcake.
If You Give a Cat a Cupcake by Laura Numeroff. If you give a cat a cupcake, he'll ask for some sprinkles to go with it. When you give him the sprinkles, he might spill some on the floor. Cleaning up will make him hot, so you'll give him a bathing suit and take him to the beach. He'll want to go in the water and build a sand castle too. Then he'll look for seashells. He'll find a few other things as well. He'll put them in his pail and try to pick it up, but it'll be too heavy. He'll decide he needs to work out at the gym. First, he'll warm up on the treadmill. Then he'll lift a weight or two. He might even try a karate class. After the gym, he'll want to go to the park. When you get there, he'll see the rocks. He'll climb as high as he can go. At the top, he'll see the lake. He'll want you to take him rowing. He'll be the captain, and you'll have to row. Then he'll notice the merry-go-round and want to go for a ride. He'll want you to go for a ride, too. You'll choose the horse with the purple mane, and he'll get on the whale. The whale will remind him of the science museum. He'll ask you to take him there. First, he'll find the dinosaurs. Then he'll visit the Hall of Apes. When the museum closes, you'll be the last to leave. On the way home, you'll pass by the beach. You'll help him gather all of his things. Then he'll want to race you. When you get home, he'll empty the sand from his shoes. He might spill some on the floor. Seeing the sand on the floor will remind him of the sprinkles. He'll probably ask you for some. And chances are, if you give him some sprinkles, what's he going to want?
he'll want a cupcake to go with them. Okay, now that we've read, if you give a cat a cupcake, our craft is to make a cupcake. So what you want to do is take your paper plate, and you can take your pencil, and the first thing we're going to do is we're going to make the bottom of the cupcake. We're going to make a big U in the bottom of our plate. So you're going to make a big U in the bottom of your plate. Then to make the frosting, we're just going to make a squiggly half circle, and it doesn't have to be perfect. And that's what we're going to end up with. So now, take your scissors, and you're going to cut that out. And again, if you don't know how to use scissors, just ask your grown-up to help you cut it out. And again, it doesn't have to be perfect. I'm just going to make the squiggly around the top. I'm going to go around and just make it a little bit squiggly so it looks like frosting. And it doesn't have to even be perfect the way I drew my lines. So I'm just going to go around. And then I'm going to cut out the bottom of my cupcake. And there you go. And then I'm going to make the line across so I can see where my cupcake stops and my frosting begins. So let's see. I really like chocolate cupcakes. So I'm going to color my cupcake with my brown crayon, and I'm going to make my cupcake part chocolate because that's my favorite kind of cupcake. So you can take your crayon and you can make it whatever flavor you want it to be. And just color that in. And like I said, I made mine chocolate. So now for my frosting, I think I'm going to make strawberry frosting, so I'm going to use my red crayon, and I'm going to color the top of my cupcake red for nice, delicious strawberry frosting. And if you don't have time to finish it while I'm doing mine, you can finish it after the show is over, so don't worry about that. You can always finish it after. Okay, so there's my cupcake. My strawberry frosting and my chocolate cupcake. And now to make this a puppet, we'll do the same thing we did before. We'll just turn it over. I'm going to take one of my straws and put it on the back. Take my tape. I'm going to take my tape and just put it right on the back there. And now I can tell the story of if you give a cat a cupcake, with my cupcake puppet.
Okay, children, now that we've finished making our cupcake, we'll read the third book that I brought by Laura Numeroff. And I chose this book because Winny and Nan just got back from Maine. We were in Maine on vacation. And when you go to Maine, you see a lot of signs that tell you there's moose around. We didn't see any, but I'm sure there's a lot of moose up there. But I don't know if the moose that live in Maine eat muffins, but this one does. So the name of this story is, If You Give a Moose a Muffin.
If You Give a Moose a Muffin by Laura Numeroff. If You Give a Moose a Muffin, he'll want some jam to go with it. So you bring out some of your mother's homemade blackberry jam. When he's finished eating the muffin, he'll want another, and another, and another. When they're all gone, he'll ask you to make more. You'll have to go to the store to get some muffin mix. When he opens the door and feels how chilly it is, he'll ask to borrow a sweater. When he puts the sweater on, he'll notice one of the buttons is loose. He'll ask for a needle and thread. He'll start sewing. The button will remind him of the puppets his grandmother used to make. So he'll ask for some old socks. He'll make sock puppets. When they're done, he'll want to put on a puppet show. He'll need some cardboard and paints. Then he'll ask you to help make the scenery. When the scenery is finished, he'll get behind the couch, but his antlers will stick out. So he'll ask for something to cover them up. You'll bring him a sheet from your bed. When he sees the sheet, he'll remember he wants to be a ghost for Halloween. He'll try it on and shout, "Boo!" It'll scare him so much, he'll knock over the paints. So he'll use the sheet to clean up the mess. Then he'll ask for some soap to wash it out. He'll probably want to hang the sheet up to dry. He'll go outside to put it on the clothesline. When he's out in the yard, he'll see your mother's blackberry bushes. Seeing the blackberries will remind him of her jam. He'll probably ask you for some. And chances are, if you give him the jam, what's he gonna want? He'll want a muffin to go with it. Okay, now that we've finished, if you give a moose a muffin, we're going to make our own moose. And this is the way it's going to look when we finish. So to make our moose, what you're going to need is, you're going to need three paper plates this time. One for the face and one for each of the antlers. So let's take our first one first and make our face. And we're going to make a bubble letter T. And T looks like this. So a T, the first part we're going to make is the top of the T. So we're going to make it look like a bubble letter. And we're going to make a big top of the T. Then for the moose's nose, we're going to make the bottom of our T a bubble letter like that. So the first thing we're going to do is cut that out. So let's cut out our bubble letter T. And again, if you need help, ask someone to help you cut that out, and we'll be ready to go. I'm just going to go around and cut this out, and I'll have the face and the nose for my moose. So there we go. Okay, so there we have that. So now we need to make the antlers for our moose. So we have two paper plates. And we're going to use our hand to make the antlers for the moose. And sometimes you've done this to make a turkey. You've used your hands to make a turkey. We're going to do something very similar. I'm going to put my hand on the paper plate, but I'm going to put these two fingers together, and I'm going to put these two fingers together. And I'm going to go around them with your pencil. So I'm going to come up this way, and I'm going to go around these two. Then I'm going to go around these two, and I'm going to go around my thumb and come down. And that's one antler. And I'm going to do the same thing on the other paper plate. So I'm going to put my hand here, put these two fingers together and these two fingers together. And I'm going to go around and around and around. And there I have my two antlers. So again, I'm going to cut these out quickly. And they don't have to be perfect, because a moose's antlers are kind of jaggedy. They're not always smooth and perfect. So don't worry about that. Just do the best you can to cut it out. And then we'll put him together. So here we go. We've got this one almost done. And in the bottom here, I'm just going to go around and make the bottom round. So there's one. Put that over there. I'll cut out the other one. Go around. There we are. And again, it doesn't have to be perfect, because the moose's antlers aren't perfect. Okay. And I'm just going to go right around the bottom here. And there we are. So now I'm going to put them together. But before I do, I'm going to color them in. I'm going to color him in before I put him together. So here's his face. So a moose, generally, usually, a moose is brown. So I'm going to take my brown crayon, and I'm going to color him brown. Okay, I'm going to color the face of my moose brown. Okay, and again, if you don't finish, you can finish after the show. And my moose, I'm going to give my moose pretty blue eyes like I did before. So I'm going to color one eye over here. I'm going to color one eye over here. And I'm going to be a little bit fancy. I'm going to take my black crayon and put those little black dots in the middle like we have. There. So there's my moose's eyes. And now he needs his nose. So I'm going to take my pink crayon and give him his nose. So here's one part of his nose, and here's the other part. I'm going to color those in. So now he has his nose. And my moose is a happy moose, so I'm going to give him a happy face. I'm going to give him a happy smile. And you can use your pink, or I used my red crayon. So there's his face. And if we look at the picture of the moose in our story, his antlers look like they're sort of a gray color. So I happen to have a gray crayon, but if you don't have a gray crayon, you can just use your black crayon and do it very lightly. So I'm going to do that. And I'm going to color his antlers that light black or gray color. So we're just going to color in his antlers. We'll do that quickly. And it doesn't have to be perfect. I'm just going to color those in. Do the best you can. Okay, so there's one antler all done. And now I'll do the other one. I'll do the other one quickly. Okay, and we're almost done. We'll have our moose all made. Okay, so now to put him together, I'm going to turn it over, and I'm going to put one antler here, and I'm going to put one antler there, and I'm going to get my tape, and I'm going to tape the antlers in the back, and I'm going to tape the other antler, and then I'm going to take my straw and put my straw on the back. And tape my straw onto the back of my moose. And then to keep it steady so his antlers stay up straight, I'm going to also put a piece of tape on the front here so that his antlers stand up straight. And there we have our moose.
Okay, children, I hope you enjoyed the stories that I brought for you today and the crafts that we made to go with them, all by Laura Numeroff. We certainly enjoyed sharing them with you. But before we say goodbye, I brought one more book by Laura Numeroff. And Winnie and I would like to read this and share this with you before we say goodbye. And this is called What Puppies Do Best. And this, as I said, is also by Laura Numeroff. Puppies can wake you up in the morning. Try to climb onto your bed and give you a kiss. Puppies can chase a ball and learn how to sit and give you their paw. Puppies can dig holes in the yard. They can track mud into the house and make a big mess. Puppies can greet you when you get home and run in circles and roll over for a belly rub. Could do that. Puppies can go on walks, make friends with other puppies, and run alongside you. Puppies can play tug of war and take a bath and get you all wet. Puppies can snuggle with you and get cozy in their bed and give you a kiss good night. But best of all, puppies can give you lots and lots of love. Well, thank you, boys and girls, for sharing this time with us. Winnie and I would like to say goodbye for now, and hope to see you again very soon. Goodbye.